35 days. 35 days of federal workers rationing asthma medicine for their kids, sleeping in cars, driving Uber, late night shifts just to make ends meet, and this man is not getting a single penny for his wall. 35 days, and the people are applauding him. This man single-handedly shut down the government. It is shameful. Dana Bash, I'm starting with you. I heard no explanation as to why he did this and why he accepted this deal. 35 days later, he still is not getting what he wants.
There's a four-letter word to describe what we just saw, and that's cave. There's no other way to describe it. The president caved after, as you said, more than 30 days, after all of the real, real world ramifications of what has gone on. He hasn't gotten a dime for his wall. But it's because things have gotten so bad, obviously. We know that not just from common sense, but from reporting, that he realized he didn't have a choice but to do exactly what Democrats have been asking him to do since day one. You want to have a negotiation, Mr. President? Great, we'll have a negotiation. But let's reopen the government first and then have the negotiation. That is what's happening now. It was exactly what was asked of him by Democrats and some Republicans, to be fair, back when the shutdown began. The one thing I will say that he did say at the very beginning, before he went on with his messaging opportunity, taking advantage of the fact that all of the networks were taking this event live, he did hold out the potential for doing something else. And I have been told by a couple of Republican sources that that is the executive action, perhaps a national emergency, something else that he could do with his own power. Obviously, mm-hmm. we talked about it could be and would be challenged in the courts. But my guess is, as he's going to see the coverage, that is, there's no other way to describe it other than a cave, he might be itching to do something that shows that he at least is doing something within his power. Mm-hmm.